Now let's take another look at job order costing. This time we'll focus on external reporting. That is, how do we record the journal entries that support the financial statements? Our focus will be on the production costs for a manufacturer, and we'll start with raw material costs. When raw material is purchased, whether it is direct or indirect, it will increase the raw material inventory account. And you will credit cash or accounts payable. So this is no different than what you learned before in your first accounting course. If you buy inventory, it will increase the inventory account, which is a current asset. Notice that it does not matter if the costs are direct or indirect material. Now, when raw material are used, you must discern, is this a direct material or is this an indirect material? If it is a direct material, you are going to debit work in process inventory and credit raw material inventory. This shows that materials were drawn from the storeroom and put on the production line. If it is an indirect material, you will debit manufacturing overhead, since it is an actual overhead cost, and you will credit raw material inventory. Note that a materials requisition form is just a form that shows that you're authorized to take materials out of the storeroom. The reason that is important to you is twofold. First, you'd like to be familiar with these terms upon graduation, but also, if you see in a problem that material was requisitioned from the storeroom, you know that all that means is material was used. Next up, factory labor costs. This will be the gross earnings, the fringe benefits, all of the payroll taxes, anything that is required to pay factory labor. Once again, you will need to distinguish between direct and indirect labor. Direct labor, you will debit work in process inventory, and you will credit cash or wages payable. Take a minute to think about what this means. You see that factory wages were paid. You would normally think this would be a wages expense account. But because it is direct labor, which is a direct product cost, it will go into the work in process inventory. These laborers worked to create inventory. So we'll record their cost as an asset. If it is indirect labor, you will identify that as an actual overhead cost. Therefore, you'll debit manufacturing overhead and you'll credit cash or wages payable. Now, manufacturing overhead costs. You learned previously that we use a predetermined overhead rate to assign cost to inventory. Now you need to understand that the manufacturing overhead account is used to keep track of two things. You will debit overhead when actual overhead costs are incurred. So if factory supplies are used, debit manufacturing overhead. If a factory maintenance worker is paid, debit manufacturing overhead. If factory utilities are paid, debit manufacturing overhead. You will credit this account when costs are assigned to inventory. This is also known as overhead applied. So your T account initially will look something like this. On the debit side, when you incur overhead costs, such as indirect material used, indirect labor cost, or factory rent, insurance, depreciation, maintenance, utilities, any of those other facilities type costs. If it's on the factory, it will be recorded as a debit to manufacturing overhead. And then you will put your manufacturing overhead applied cost in the credit side of this account. So it is used to keep track of two different things. It's very different than your other accounts you've learned about. It's not increased with a debit nor increased with a credit. Two different things, are recorded here. Now do remember that the overhead account is closed at the end of the period. You will eliminate the balance in overhead by adjusting cost of goods sold if the amount is not significant, or you will allocate to work in process inventory, finished goods inventory, and cost of goods sold if the balance is material. Now, if you think about this, the wrong amount of overhead will flow through work in process, finished goods, and cost of goods sold. What this is saying is if it's not significant in dollar amount, we're simply going to do what's easy and close it to cost of goods sold. A debit balance in the overhead account means it's underapplied, and a credit balance means it's overapplied. Now in this class, we're going to stick to the basics, and we're going to assume that any under or overapplied overhead is insignificant or immaterial, and so we're going to close it to cost of goods sold. We are not really going to study the calculations for allocating among work in process, finished goods, and cost of goods sold. Now let's look at the specifics of the journal entry to close these amounts to cost of goods sold. If it is underapplied and you have a debit balance, you will need to debit cost of goods sold and credit manufacturing overhead to get that account to zero. If, on the other hand, you have a credit balance and it's overapplied, you will need to debit manufacturing overhead to get it to a zero balance and credit cost of goods sold. You can see then the amount is plugged to cost of goods sold. The effect of these entries will be to get the manufacturing overhead account to zero before you prepare financial statements. Let's look at a brief example about under or over applied overhead. Assume Alpha Electronics Inc. applies overhead based on an overhead rate of $2 per labor dollar. Further, assume direct labor costs totaled $52,000 for 4,000 direct labor hours during the most recent period. Actual manufacturing overhead cost incurred during the period totaled $100,000. When the manufacturing overhead account is closed, assuming the amount is immaterial, will it increase or decrease the following? So we're going to look at the effect on cost of goods sold and then gross margin. Anytime you are asked to look at the overhead account, you need to identify or calculate the predetermined rate. Here, they gave us the rate to be $2 per direct labor dollar. So they believe for every direct labor dollar paid, they incur twice as much overhead cost. Other important numbers to note, if you're going to analyze this, is that the actual activity was 52,000 direct labor dollars, and we actually incurred $100,000 of overhead. So when we set up our T account, our actual overhead cost will go on the debit side and our applied overhead cost will go on the credit side. The actual overhead cost is $100,000. That means factory rent plus factory insurance plus factory depreciation, etc., added up to be $100,000 for the period. The applied overhead will be $2 per direct labor dollar times 52,000 direct labor dollars. That's $104,000. You can see that we should have assigned $100,000 of overhead cost to inventory, but we did assign $104,000 to inventory. That's because the $100,000 was not known at the time of production. We find that we have a $4,000 credit balance. What that means is we assigned too much cost to inventory, so we've over-applied overhead. To close that out, we will need to debit that account. And we will plug it to cost of goods sold. Now, cost of goods sold, what kind of account is that? If you said expense account, you are right. And a credit to an expense account will decrease the account. So the answer to question one is decrease. Now, since gross margin is sales minus cost of goods sold, and cost of goods sold is now lower, you can expect that that would increase gross margin. Now, next up is just a summary of what we just talked about. These diagrams will be useful when you go to prepare journal entries on your own. The first one looks at how costs flow from work in process inventory to finished goods inventory to cost of goods sold. You will debit work in process when direct material are used, direct labor is recorded, or overhead is applied. These costs will attach to the units, and when the units are completed, the cost will be transferred to finished goods inventory. It is still shown as a current asset, but when the goods are sold, that cost becomes an expense. It goes to our income statement to be written off through cost of goods sold. Now, some of you will like this general model of cost flows for product cost. It shows the T accounts for the new accounts that you're learning about. And it can be very useful in preparing the journal entries. Even if you don't use all of these accounts, I do recommend that you look closely at the manufacturing overhead account. Let's take a look. You will record actual overhead cost on the debit side. So again, factory utilities paid, debit overhead. You will assign applied overhead cost on the credit side of this account. If you have a balance at the end on the debit side, it's under applied. And a credit balance at the end of the period, it is over applied. Next up, we'll want to work an example, so tune back in soon.